Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Clemson is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. Taken at the 5. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 29. Quick throw, and he's taken down right around the 42-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
Throws, and it's incomplete.
Here's a case of a quarterback so eager to make a play that he failed to see the danger of that attempt and nearly gave the ball away.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 42. He gets rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
47 right. And down he goes at the 18. A heck of a play by the receiver.
We talk all the time about the emotions of college football. This play was definitely an emotionally charged play. What a way for the wideout to make a statement in this game.
From the 18-yard line, first down. And they make the stop around the 17-yard line. Brought down at about the 17-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Oklahoma.
Got a receiver and he dropped it. It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. Virginia could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks away. And this one doesn't have the distance. Well, they leave 3 points on the field there. No score here. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He scrambled. Under pressure, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
And they'll probably try to throw here as they line up on third down and 14. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. So that'll make it fourth down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
So lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. He's taken down at the 35.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Tackle at the 25-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
Gets it. He's in space. He's tackled at about the 13. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 13. The offense gets set as they attempt to put an end to these red zone blues. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. The middle. Touchdown, Cavs.
When you're that close to the end zone, it's always a smart play to find your blockers and follow them into the end zone.
And he tacks on the extra point. It was a 5-play, 48-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The score now, 7-0. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And he's tackled right around the 46-yard line. Slings it. Tackle made at the 47-yard line. Dumps it complete over the middle. They'll bring him down at the 41. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. To his receiver, and he hits him hard at the 18-yard line. He gets out to about the 8. First and goal, and a touchdown ties it, folks. Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. Throws it, and it's caught for the touchdown.
I like how the quarterback, the offensive line, and the receivers made a concerted effort to get into the end zone.
The extra point to tie this game up. and he converts the extra point. An 8-play, 70-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Reed takes it at the 4. He's out to the 30. And he's tackled at the 33-yard line. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Little handoff. Makes it to the 47. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers.
Set, 10, 19.
He's at the 30. And he's taken down at the 17-yard line. That was a huge lift.
Brad, you're right. A run like that can really get the momentum rolling.
So it's first and 10 after the big run. There's a strike complete, and he's taken down at about the 15-yard line. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 15. And down he goes at the 13. Scrambling. And they make the stop at the 7-yard line.
Good coverage by the defense, but they have to be aware of this quarterback's tendency to scramble around and pick up some yards.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. He makes it to the 6-yard line. They'll give it off here. Brought down around the 4-yard line. Just inside the 5. Second down. They're packed in tight on the line. Scrambling around. Shows some moves and he's in. Touchdown. He didn't see anyone open, so he just took it in himself.
This quarterback is fearless, and the defense needs to either spy him or walk the safeties up when they've got the ball down near the goal line.
And he missed it. He missed the extra point. Delaney is lined up to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. And they got him. We're through one quarter. Virginia's lead is 6. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. Heading for the corner. He's taken down at the 42. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Virginia up 6. Atkins on the right side. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. It's second down, 6 to go. Ball on the 39. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. He's taken down at about the 29-yard line. Right around the 26-yard line. From the 26-yard line, it's second down. Makes it to the 11.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? He better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
Throws it away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 11-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's tackled right around the 6-yard line. Virginia with a 6-point lead. And he throws it away. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. The kick is up, and it's through the uprights. Delaney has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. And they get nice yardage on that run. Makes it out to about the 39. He's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. Slides down. He makes his way to about the 45. He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work.
And they push him out at the 32. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
He steps out at the 28. Overton gains about 4 yards there. From the 28-yard line, second down. Man, oh, what a hit.
I think he could have taken a risk down the field, but he played it safe instead, and that's one of the keys to winning ball games.
And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. Well defended by this defense.
The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make plays like that.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. This is the 11th play of this drive. Quick throw. What a play, and that is first and goal.
Mike Moore. There.
Nice run there.
He's got a nose for the end zone. What more can you say? He wasn't giving up on that run until he was in for the score.
He makes the PAT. Potter has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Caught at the 8. He's out to the 30. Tackle at the 35. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Virginia with a 2-point advantage. Quick pass. He's at midfield. And he's finally shoved out at the 39-yard line. From the 39-yard line, first down. He gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Five wide. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's tackled in the open field. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28. Fires out to his wideout. Touchdown, Cavaliers.
Wide out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
Well, that had to be a miscue of some kind or a mental error by the defense. This wide receiver was just too open, for there not to be some kind of mistake by the defense. I'm sure the defensive coordinator is going to want to get his defense on the sideline and to make sure everybody's on the same page.
And he adds the extra point. Delaney gets set to kick this one away. From the 5-yard line, he's to the 20. They'll bring him down to the 37-yard line. Clemson's gotten the play out of their quarterback, and you expect that that was going to happen. But, I mean, what is happening here? Somebody else is going to have to come to the forefront, or this thing's going to be over.
If you would have told me before the game that this quarterback would have played like this to the first quarter and a half or so, I would have thought this team would have been leading this game. You're right. Something has got to happen where his teammates, the rest of this group, they've got to raise their game if they want to have any chance of winning this game.
And he just gets rid of it. Third and 11 here. Ball on the 36.
Mike check 36.
Wants to go long and does. Can't connect. He was off target that time.
Yeah, you can see his arm strength, but here he overthrew the intended receiver on the deep route.
Brought down at the 39. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out.
Here we go, here we go. 3-9.
He scrambled. And he's tackled at the 48. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Get some open field. He's at the 40. Loose football. Now the defense has it. The safety got the corner. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain.
The defense wasn't fooled at all on the option, and it was their discipline that created that turnover.
So they're just about set to get the game going again. Now he tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down at about the 39-yard line. He gets rid of this one. Defense looked like it jumped early there.
Concentration lapse right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Pulls it in, and that's a first down. And he tackles him hard at the 28-yard line. It to his wide receiver, and he's got another one, and he's taken down around the 10-yard line. It's first down, and he'll be looking for 6 points here.
That's a smart play here by the quarterback. He threw it into the window the zone coverage gave him. Nice pass and a nice job by the receiver running the slant.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. 7 yards there on the option pitch to the halfback. The Tigers are going to call their second timeout. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. They'll drop him for a loss. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. Now he's scrambling. He gets sacked on the play. It's fourth down. This should be an easy field goal. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. It's up, and he got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Clemson is ready to kick it away. Reed fields it at the two. And down he goes at the 29. A fumble ended this offense's last drive. Let's see as they come out on the field what they'll do this time around.
The defense, I'm sure, will be aggressive again. They love going for the strip and attacking the football.
Gains his way to the 40-yard line. Virginia is going to use their first time out of the half here. From their own 40-yard line, first down, Virginia is up by six. Zips it to the back. Brought down around the 46-yard line. Virginia is going to have to use their second time out of the half. Let's see if the quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. He lets it fly. Missed him. We've had a shootout through two quarters here with nothing but offense. The Cavaliers lead 23-17.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here completely locked in on that first half. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being, and we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. From the 8-yard line, he's out to the 30, and he's taken down at the 30-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete.
I know this quarterback trusts his arm and his receivers, but he's got to know when not to throw the ball. He didn't have any room at all, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
That pass didn't look exactly right when it left his hand. Sometimes you don't get a great grip on the ball, and it comes out a little wobbly.
There's a strike complete, and he's down. They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
We're about set to start things up again. Virginia with a six-point lead. Complete. It's the junior. He's tackled at the 48-yard line. From their own 48-yard line, it's first down. The middle. Atkins picks up about 4 yards on the delayed handoff. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Gets it out, and he's met immediately. Punt. Kendrick fields it at the 22. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. And he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Run to the left there. He's at midfield. Makes it out to about the 49. At the 40-yard line. He gets to about the 27-yard line. Taken down right around the 14-yard line. Looks to a receiver. Touchdown.
You've got to give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
Trying to take the lead. Here's the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he'll return this one from the 7. And he's tackled at the 24-yard line. The Tigers' defense really looked pathetic in that first half, Kirk, and now they're doing a nice job.
Well, obviously, they've made some adjustments after the first half, and it's paid off for them. I think right now they're tuned in to what this offense is trying to do, and I think they're also just playing with a little bit more of a chip on their shoulder.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And down he goes, around the 35-yard line. From their own 35-yard line, first down. And they make the stop, around the 36-yard line.
Thank you. 14! Blue 14!
Motion, motion.
Tackle made at the 46. First and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
Terrific coverage, and when you clog up passing lanes like that, you can force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he's tackled around the 41-yard line. In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Virginia's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie. I guess at least not today.
No, not today. They've played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
They'll bring him down right around the 24-yard line. Clemson with a one-point lead. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Got some open field. Makes it out to about the 40. Fires it out, and he's taken down right around the 44-yard line. Little handoff, and they'll bring him down behind the line. Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50.
I smell fear in that offense.
Mike Ford.
Here's the halfback on the screen. Brought down at the 46-yard line. Under heavy pressure. He's scrambling. Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 46. Finds his man and they take him down immediately. Clemson is up one. Up the middle for a nice game. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Excellent open field tackle.
He fights forward to about the 10. He makes it to the 9. The halfback picks up a yard.
Nice play here by the senior to make the sure tackle. It's not very often that someone's able to shake this guy.
And here's the 14th play of the drive. He gets out to about the 9-yard line. They're going to go for the easy 3 here. Kicks away, and it's through the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. From the 5-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 28.
Clemson coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Steps out of bounds at the 31-yard line.
It's all about chipping away at the defense. Even short yardage completions can have a way of building a quarterback's confidence.
From their own 31-yard line, it's second down.
Blue 14! Blue 14!
Straight run here, and he's got nowhere to go. Receiver, and he dropped it.
They looked a little sluggish on that series. I'm curious to see if they pick things up when they get the ball back.
Griffin is waiting for the snap. And he just got drilled. The Tigers have got to remember that they've still got a fight on their hands in this football game.
Yeah, they cannot afford to get sloppy. Remember the first half, how bad they looked. And as good as things are going right now, with an entire quarter to go, they got to continue to play good football.
This has been a fun one if you like offense. The shootout continues as we head to the fourth. 27-23, Tigers. Back to the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter.
A score here might effectively end this one.
Clemson is up by 4. And he's level at the 49-yard line. He'll get it again. He's at the 40. He gets hit out of bounds.
At about the 37-yard line.
Got the corner. He makes it to the 35-yard line. And they get a few yards on the halfback option. Gains his way to the 26-yard line.
Watch the pass. Mark Schick, 33.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Here's a run. And he's tackled after positive yardage. From the 15-yard line, first down. And now he's got room to run.
Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. Clemson holds a four-point lead. Now he's scrambling. Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
From the one-yard line, second down. He's going to try and scramble. Got a man open, touchdown. He has three scoring tosses in the game now.
What I'm noticing more and more about this guy is he's very patient with the ball, and it's resulting in some nice scores, just like we've seen today.
And he adds the extra point. Potter gets set to kick this one away. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 26. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out. He's tackled at the 36-yard line. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Zips it to the tailback, incomplete. And they're going to get somebody for interference on that play. Let's see who the call is on.
Defense.
That was an easy call for the official and a good pickup for the offense. Penalties will just kill you.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 32. Quick pass. He's to the 40. He's pushed out of bounds at the 45. And for Dubois, he racks up more yardage, and that brings his receiving total to 100.
You know, Brad, this guy continues to make plays. If I'm the defensive coordinator, I would put a corner on him down low underneath, and I'd put a safety over top of him. Put two defenders on him to try to slow him down, because right now, one-on-one coverage, he is destroying.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line.
Blue 14.
Atkins on the give. Gets to about the 44-yard line. Tries to buy some time. Tackle around the 42-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 35. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals.
Down. 10-19. Motion, motion, motion.
Hands it to the back. He fights forward to about the 40. Zips one over to the right. Incomplete.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Stopped behind the line. down now, and they need to get it out to midfield. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Throws complete, and he's got space to work. He's out of bounds at the 47. He fields the punt at the 16, and he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Fires that quickly, incomplete. From their own 24-yard line. Second down. Five wide. Go. Scrambling around. And they got him.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page. And they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
It's always tough trying to put the ball out of the defender's reach, but where your guy can still come down with it in bounds. It takes a lot more precision than it looks.
Kendrick is back deep to return the punt. Kendrick takes it at the 47.
You're always looking for the home run return, the big highlight. Didn't happen there, but he still got him a couple yards.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Less than 3 minutes in the game. And down he goes, around the 44-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
He got right in there and popped the ball carrier. This senior just doesn't back down from anyone.
It's second and nine. Ball on the 44-yard line. Some daylight. He's taken down at the 35-yard line. Virginia's going to take their first time out of the half. He's on the run. Tackle made at the 27-yard line. Virginia's going to have to use their second time out of the half. From the 27-yard line, first down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Virginia will take their last time out. They'll work the left. Inside the 10. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. First and goal from the 5, and looking to cap this off with a touchdown. Tackled after a decent pickup. Sideline just erupting over there as their quarterback got to the end zone.
What a run. What a big moment in this game. The quarterback takes it into the end zone for a potential game-winning touchdown. They have good reason to be celebrating on those sidelines.
He makes the PAT. Potter has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. Spikes the ball. Second and 10. Ball on their own 39. Fires it out. Brought down around the 43-yard line.
Check, check. H. Bruin.
And he stops the clock with a spike. Griffin is the punter. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, Clemson 41, Virginia 23. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.